Well, it's day 26. We've made it. I'm impressed. Hey, you're one of the few who do. If you're listening to my voice right now, I have got to tell you, I have to compliment you. Think about it. How many people do you think there are in this world who really want to change their life, who say they want to at least, but never do anything about it? What percentage of people say they want to do something and they make an investment in a program but never listen to it? People don't want to have effort. They want rewards, but they don't want to take a lot of action. Well, the bottom line is you and I both know that that's not how life works. You don't get success without an investment. There's no free lunch. And for you, you've really gone for it. Now, the challenge doesn't end here. The purpose of today's tape is only to do one primary thing. That is to challenge you to make sure that this is not the end, but the beginning. You know, there's several life paths that you can head down. There's the path of the person who is what I call the dabbler. The dabbler path isn't your style, or you wouldn't have made it to day 26. The dabbler goes and does something just in the beginning when it feels really good. You know, when it's brand new and they go out there and they crank like crazy. And let's say they're learning a new sport. They go out to play tennis and boy, it's so much fun to knock that ball back and forth. But the problem with the dabbler is they eventually hit a plateau. You know the place, don't you? It comes out in anything. Listening to these tapes, it probably happened around day 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, somewhere in that range. If you're out and learning how to play tennis, it happens after about 2 weeks. Where all of a sudden, you know, you're working just as hard, but you're not getting quite as much from it in the short term. You know, it's like you keep hitting the ball, it doesn't seem to be making that big of an improvement anymore. I mean, when you're brand new, anything looks like an improvement. And so what happens for a dabbler is they get bored, they get tired, they give up, and they quit. And what do? They go start another game. These people come to the end of their life, and they're the living example of the phrase, I wish I woulda, or I shoulda. The second life path is what I call the stressor. The stressor is the person who goes out there, and boy, they're going to make things work. They're going to make it happen no matter what. And they just push and push and push and push and push. And you know what? They crank things up and they succeed. They get out there and hit the ball as hard as they can on the tennis court, you know? They were here there every day. They probably listened to these tapes more than once a day, probably 5 or 6 times, because they wanted to get it right. But they also hit a plateau. And when they hit the plateau, what they do is they just keep pushing and pushing and pushing, and usually they burn themselves out. That's not the way to make it happen either. The way to succeed long-term is a path known as mastery. And the master is someone who understands the way to have ultimate lifelong success is to practice fundamentals every single day. The master never gets bored. The master says, let me practice what I know until I perfect it, and even then it can be improved. That person goes out and they work very hard and they have that same acceleration where things are going really great in the first couple weeks, but when they hit the plateau, instead of quitting or getting stressed, they just continue to look for the answers and how to move to the next level. Because with mastery comes a certain level of patience, no less urgency, but a sense of patience that says, if I have to make an adjustment and take a half step back in order to get 10 steps forward, I will do it in a heartbeat. That's what mastery is about, and that's the path I challenge you to take. Daily, consistent action towards your life's purpose. How do you change your life? Well, the lessons are in these tapes. You have more than enough technology now to make the changes in your emotions and your behaviors. The key is, what are you going to do with it now? You know, most tape programs have 4, 5, or 6 tapes on them, and you just listen to those same tapes over and over and over and over again to embed them. We went for a different approach here, but it doesn't mean you certainly can't go back and review them. Remember, repetition is the mother of skill. This program has been designed for you as a lifelong system for personal success, something you could go back through at any time that you want, or you can just pick up one little tape area, like maybe on finances, for example, or maybe on managing your state, so that you can get a quick review and get yourself right back up to speed where you're really using the tools that can help you shape your life the way you want it. So let me give you the short-term challenge first. Challenge number one is, I'm going to ask you for the next 4 days to follow up in the following way. One, I realize you're a human being, and so there are probably exercises along the way that for whatever reasons you skipped through them. I'm going to ask you to review your tapes now, review your success journal, and see if there are any exercises you didn't do, or maybe you didn't do as thoroughly as you could. I'd like to ask you to, number one, go back and do those. Give yourself that benefit. Two, today, as soon as this tape is done, I want you to review your goals from the goal setting workshop. And I'd like you, if you would, to pick out 4 specific goals that you are absolutely committed to achieving in the next year. Your top 4 goals. And make sure they're specific. Once you've written down those 4 goals, I want you in your success journal to write down at least a paragraph as to why you absolutely are committed to achieving those goals. Remember what we talked about earlier. Reasons come first, answers come second. In other words, if you can get a big enough why, you can figure out how to achieve your goals. But that's the second key. Why will you absolutely achieve these goals? And make it a must. Make it something that will really drive you. Part of how you can do that, of course, is to write down also what will you miss out on if you don't achieve these goals. But really sell yourself. And then step three is your challenge is to develop a plan under each one of these goals as to how you're going to go about achieving them. And the minimum that plan must have is something that you can do in the next 4 days to start achieving those goals. I don't care how big the goal is. There's something you can do tomorrow. Maybe it's a phone call. Maybe it's a phone call to get some information about how to do something. Maybe for you it's going to the library and doing some research. Maybe it's making the commitment to some people around you that you're no longer going to do something and setting yourself up so there's no way you can turn back. I don't know what it is, but I want you to make sure that you immediately develop a plan, and the minimum again is you've got to have the first step that you can do right away, something in the next 4 days before these 30 days are complete. Would you be willing to go for it? I hope so. In fact, I know you will. If you've gone through this many days, you've got too much invested not to go for it, don't you? So go for it and make sure you do that. And the fourth short-term challenge is this. Make certain that for at least the next 10 days, you continue to do your morning questions. In other words, each morning when you wake up, you want to ask yourself 3, 4, 5 questions that really put you in a powerful and positive state of mind. Make sure you do that so that it becomes a habit, so that pretty soon when you wake up, your brain begins to ask yourself, God, what am I happy about in my life? Or what could I be happy about? What am I excited about? What am I proud of in my life right now? What am I grateful for? Who do I love and who loves me? If those kinds of questions are being asked continuously, you're going to get some wonderful answers that will make you feel phenomenal, and everything that happens in your life will be filtered through those emotions and states. One way to make sure you feel more joy in your life is not to let your life just run around in your brain. What do I mean? Don't just talk to yourself and make pictures in your head. Do what we've begun to do here as a lifetime process, meaning not only every day looking for a way to improve, but get yourself a hardbound journal and keep a journal each day. Write down what's happened. What did you learn? What did you discover? What did you create? Who did you contribute to? What pain did you have? What happened there in your life that, hey, that woke you up and made you look at things in a new way? When I go to a seminar, I write down the ideas that I learned, so I don't just let them go in my head and disappear. If I read a book and I find something that's useful, I jot it down. If I listen to a tape and there's something great there, I jot it down. If I watch a movie and I get an idea, I jot it down. I've got a place to put my ideas for better living. I call it my textbook for better living. And I've got years and years of them. And fortunately, since I didn't do them on loose leaf binders or on little scraps of paper, they're books in my library. And I can go there and pull them off my shelf and look at the goals I had then. And what I can do is literally trace my growth. You know, sometimes you're so close to yourself, you don't give yourself credit for where you've been and where you are now. It's hard to measure yourself. So what you need to do is have a journal, because then you can look and see how your life has changed. Plus, the great thing about journals is this. Remember what I said earlier. If your life is worth living, it's worth recording. See, if you have a hardbound journal, those things will be around for years. They'll be around after you're gone if they're taken care of. And what that becomes is a gift you can give your children. They can literally go back and see, God, here's where my dad was, or your grandchildren, here's where grandpa was, here's where he was in his life, and here's what he was thinking, here's what he's feeling, and they can learn by your experience. They can learn and feel a connection with you even when you're gone. What a nice gift. So my challenge to you is, make sure every day you're learning. Make sure every day you're recording what you're learning. Make sure every day you're acting on what you're learning. Walk your talk. Don't make your life just livable. Make it memorable. Remember a couple of key ideas. Number one, remember you can change anything you want to change immediately. All you have to do is follow those four steps. One, decide what it is that you really want. Don't get caught up in the problem. Decide what do you want. Focus on that. Two, get a plan. The best way to get a plan is to immediately find somebody to model. Think of somebody who's already gotten the result. Find out what they do, or the best of your ability, create the plan right now. Step three, don't wait a day. Take action. Use your personal power. Follow through. Don't let a day go by. When you set a goal, when you make a decision, make sure that you don't leave the sight of that decision without taking some kind of action that moves you towards achieving your goal. And finally, four, be flexible. Constantly notice whether what you're doing is working or not. Don't get stuck in one path or one approach. And if you discover that what you're trying isn't working, change your approach. Just keep changing and you'll eventually get exactly what you want. Not only can you change anything in your life, but if you really want to master your life, there are also four key elements. And those elements are, for life mastery, one, you must master your own mental and emotional states. In other words, I want you to remember